The Philippines will take bold steps to transition to renewable and alternative energy technologies in a secure and sustainable manner. Recognizing that a cleaner energy future is anchored on the supply of critical minerals, ASEAN should now start enhancing regional cooperation towards boosting the region's strategic industrial metals and minerals value chain. Third, ASEAN must be united in urging developed countries to fulfill their long-standing commitments to the Paris Agreement. Although developing countries such as the Philippines only account for less than 1% of global emissions, our countries bear the brunt of the devastating impacts of climate change. Developed countries have a moral obligation to support adaptation and mitigation efforts through, for the most vulnerable countries, through technology transfer, capacity building, and climate financing. This to address loss and damage and to achieve necessary breakthroughs for climate action at a global scale. The Philippines recognizes that biodiversity can complement and synergize with ASEAN's initiatives in climate change, contributing to our efforts towards a more sustainable and resilient future. The conservation and sustainable use of biodiversity is also an intergenerational responsibility that the Philippines is proud to support through the ASEAN Center for Biodiversity. Your Majesty, Excellencies, as one community, it is imperative that we provide whole-of-community support to Timor-Leste as it continues its meaningful journey towards full ASEAN membership. Timor-Leste's membership can only strengthen our ASEAN community as it expands the reach of ASEAN's united front to face the challenges of the 21st century. As we embark on our vision for a bolder, more decisive, and cohesive ASEAN beyond 2025, let us renew our collective faith in the organization by consolidating our community-building efforts towards an ASEAN that truly matters. Thank you, Mr. Chair.